Hi, what's new in VMware Common Black Cloud Container June 2022 release? In this video, we will see the new version number for this release, the auto-enforce feature, the new container image with CBCTL included, and Helm charts for installing Carbon Black Container. See in Carbon Black UI for your operator and agent version. Remember, just edit the cluster to update CBC container. You should have operator version 5.2, agent version 2.5, and for CBCTL, just run CBCTL version to know your version. Warning, if you have only two CPUs in your Kubernetes cluster, perhaps it's better to update your cluster to use at least three or four CPUs. So, the new auto-enforce features. The common goal for DevSecOps is to enforce security standards and compliance across their platform, but they face two challenges. Challenge one, alert fatigue. Investigating many alerts can be an extremely manual process. There is no way that those could all be fixed quickly or without a tremendous number of resources. Challenge two, processes. SecOps teams don't want to block development teams from deploying new code or fixes. That's why we have added auto-enforcement in this new release. So we can enforce workload security Boolean parameters on the left, but we can also set values to quotas, to app armor, user ID, and SecComp profile. The benefit from this auto-enforce feature is that you can enforce compliance without compromising security. You gain back the control of your Kubernetes. You can quickly remediate misconfiguration and deviation from compliance standards. A technical overview of the product. In the hardening policy, now we have alert, block, or enforce. And really the top use case you need to remind is that you can eliminate the risk without blocking deployments, and you can have temporary patch until fix is available. What's the difference between all three modes, alert, block, and enforce? Imagine you want to deploy an application, demo application, with privilege. Privilege with alert mode, of course, you will have an alert, but application will run with privilege, so it's not secure. If you use a block mode, the application will be blocked, will not run, the production is stopped, and with enforce mode, the application will run, but without privilege, so it is secure. Example of the same application deployed without Carbon Black. When you will try to get the deployment from your Kubernetes cluster, you will see that your deployment, your pod that is running, has the privilege set to true. But if you have deployed using Carbon Black and an enforcement policy to block the privilege, then you will see that the application will run, but with security context, there will be no privilege. Each time Carbon Black modifies a deployment, you will have a log in the Kubernetes violation, and here you will see that the deployment has been mutated, it has been changed by Carbon Black. So we have containerized CBCTL, so a new container image is available. All instructions can be found on developer.carbonblack.com. And here we have an example of usage of CBCTL container image. What is the benefit of this container? You can see we can scan an image. We can scan Ubuntu image, for example, and see all CV and all package, etc. What's the benefit? It is easier to integrate in CI/CD pipeline because we don't need to download CBCTL binary and create a configuration file. Integration is done via a single command line, this one. So it can be integrated in Jenkins and soon in Tanzu application platform. Helm is the package manager for Kubernetes. So it is the industry standard to manage lifecycle of Kubernetes applications. So we just released on GitHub Helm charts for installing Carbon Black container. And well, now it's more easy. You don't need to have three copy pastes to install Carbon Black. It was not so hard, but now it's even simpler with Helm charts. Thank you and see you soon.